Okay, folks, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to the third round of this best of three series. It is loser's bracket. One of these guys is going out today. One will advance in the loser's bracket. And I bring you Delphi in the red trunks. He is playing Zerg right here on the Tal'Darim altar versus his opponent, Wolverine, in the yellow trunks. And he is playing Protoss.
And Wolverine, I think, is going to have a hard time on this big map, to be honest. Every game, every map, every person he's beat in this tournament, he's done it on small maps, he's done it with one base aggression, sometimes two, but I have not seen a game go past 15 minutes with Wolverine. Never. Not even standing behind him, he's either GG'd out or forced his opponent to GG. So we'll have to see this, and it is a very, very big map.
Oh yeah. Delphi is probably pretty happy right now, I'd say, with the spawn positions. Looks pretty good.
Looks pretty good indeed for Delphi.
Finally, and, he wins a coin flip.
Yeah, I mean, it's a big map indeed, and even if it was on the right-hand side, if the Protoss base was next to him instead of cross position, still super large map. But then again, you got to think about, it really doesn't matter about the size of the map sometimes. Obviously, it's going to help out with scouting. I mean, for Delphi, the probe's going to be there. But the warp function enables you to warp in directly onto your opponent's doorstep.
It's a wonderful, wonderful world in that regard. Let's see if he goes to spawning pool first, and it looks like he's done just that. Not going to risk the hatchery right now. Play it nice and safe. Spawning pool followed by extractor, and then into the hatchery for him right there. I was about to call it a nexus. I have no intention of making that mistake today. It's not going to happen.
Yeah, I mean, it's just safe play. I mean, it's completely standard that Delphi's doing this. Very cautious. One game away from advancing, or one game away from leaving
losing
this awesome tournament.
Tense.
And that is not what you want. So have to play safe. You don't want to lose to anything like a Fourgate again. And if he does, I know he's going to be very mad. He's going to be a little mad German for sure.
Little mad German. You can't say things like that. That's terrible. It's like calling... Well, actually, was it John who called? Yeah, it was. He called Huck a gnome, as I recall.
Gnome. Well, he would be a little mad German, and I'd be a little mad English caster too if he went out. A little mad English caster.
You don't like Fourgates, do you? You don't. You are biased.
I don't like Protoss, man. Yeah. I was gonna put it simple. I don't like Protoss.
Does anyone like Protoss? I hate Protoss. Although the only reason I hate Protoss is because of probe harassment. That is it. Yeah, that's the only thing I dislike. It annoys the hell out of me. My God, why would you do this? It's so horrible.
I mean, it's really funny because you know I do my coaching and stuff, and I have had people come up to me like, "Can you teach me Protoss?" And I say, "No." They're like, "Why?" I'm like, "I don't like it." And then they're like, "I'll pay you more." I'm like, "No, I'm not going to teach anybody how to play Protoss."
Well, as it turns out, actually, Apollo has a critical disadvantage while playing Protoss because he has no F key on his keyboard, so he loses automatically.
Hey, man, I don't build infestors.
Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Okay, Delphi knows what's going on. At least he thinks he does. Nice little wall off. Sneaks past there. His drone will survive. 2-gate. What are we seeing? It's only one assimilator. It may very well be the same thing. We are chrono boosting again. And honestly, what else is he going to do? But look at this. Look at the amount of scouting information Delphi has. His spread is phenomenal. He's all over the place. He's holding loads of Zelnaga watchtowers. He has overlords in place. He's ready for this.
Yeah, he's not going to be able to get inside the base because it's cross positions. Obviously, overlords taking a long time to get there. But he will, as you said, does have control of the Zelnaga towers, everyone actually, and we'll see this push when it comes out. And we are seeing a Fourgate once again by Wolverine.
Nothing else. It's to be expected. He's one game away from falling out of the tournament. Is he going to try something different now? No, he's not stupid. Of course he's going to do the same thing. However, Delphi is ready for this. Does he have every... He does. He has all four Zelnaga watchtowers. He has visibility of over half the map right now. He's going to see this coming a mile away.
And look at the Lings moving around the map looking for this pylon, which isn't there. But very, very nice map control. And he knows that this is how Wolverine will play. And he's expecting something like this. Building Lings blindly in anticipation for this. He now knows and sees the player pushing out. With that Stalker in the mix, that's not really a 3-gate expo play. And he's going to move around and see that. And he knows what's
probes
going on
with it. He knows what's coming. And the question is, how is he going to counteract this? Spinecrawler immediately coming down. Might be looking for multiple Spinecrawlers, perhaps.
Yeah, he needs to defend. The second one goes down. He's not going to rely on just one. A little bit risky. I mean, players like Mondragon, when he sees Fourgate, he actually puts down like five. Like, as long as you defend, you're going to be ahead. And probe damage. Oh, my God. Lings in the main are doing so much damage to the probes.
That was a nice sneak in right there. That is a good strategy right there. exploiting the fact that the size of this map, he's able to sneak past it. He was able to take a good number out. He takes out four, in fact. That's actually going to cripple the four gateway, I would think. It's bad enough in terms of the economy, but taking out four probes as well, that's really going to hurt him.
And now we're just waiting for this pile to finish. A round of Zealots and Sentries will most likely be incoming. And here we do see Stalker, actually. Stalker and Sentries down. And now they've actually...
Oh wow. Look at this.
Spinecrawler lifted.
He's looking for the deployment. However, the force field is actually going to prevent him from focusing fire on that Spinecrawler. And in from the back, it's a surround right here. He was ready for this one. Delphi goes in there. He is brutalizing Wolverine right now. Oh my god, it's a massacre.
Oh my god, Delphi, you've learned your lesson from that previous game and you just smashed that build wide open. And now Wolverine is on the back foot, having to build a Stargate, resorting to the kind of last option.
This isn't going to work. There's 44, 50 Zerglings on the field right now. What the hell is he going to stop him with? Harsh language. It's not going to happen. One Stalker. My God, it's endless. It's a goddamn tide. He's right into the line right here. So many Zerglings. Oh, my God. There's no way he's going to be able to stop this. It's just not going to happen. He doesn't have the Unicorn. He's building a Stargate. Why is he building a Stargate? It's not going to happen. Oh my god, here's the swarm. He breaks the line. He's in. He is in right now. However, he's split up by a force field. He's going to have to drill his way through this production line. Delphi can keep on with this. He's droning up as well. The Stargate is up for no apparent reason. And he looks for it. He's in. He's through. There's the surround. Does he have the numbers to do it, though? He did take a lot of losses. Crushes one. Crushes two. Looks for the third. He's running out of Zerglings, I'm afraid.
And yeah, indeed. Just managed to take down these two Zealots, but... does he see the Stargate, though? No, unfortunately, the Lings didn't quite see it.
Oh, my.
When it comes down to the final five or six Lings, that's when you know it's not going to work. You need to go scout exactly what's going on. And playing very safe, very cautious. Does have the Evo Chamber down in anticipation for something like this, and the Roach Warrant also, just in case. And he will stay off Lair for just a little bit longer.
Yeah, and honestly, that really did critically injure Wolverine's economy, even though he didn't actually take any probes from it. He's going to have to reinforce a lot. He threw together a four-gateway attack, which faltered almost immediately thanks to the amount of Zergling damage that was done. A very smart play by there. And Delphi, as I say, it's not critical that he didn't manage to do more damage. Personally, I would have attacked the front. Delphi spent so much time swarming, trying to get in there. He had tons of Zerglings at the back that did nothing. And therein lies the problem. Now, that Stargate was not scouted, but he's got to expect something a little bit unusual.
Scouted now.
He sees it, and he immediately puts down the Spore Crawlers and the Lairs on its way. Any kind of Void Ray play here is not going to work out so well, and we're not seeing another Void Ray coming out either.
Yeah, I mean, this is basically all in again from Wolverine. The follow-up all in, but I think the defense is just too strong. Lings and Roaches in production.
Yeah.
And I don't know if this is going to work out. Only one Void Ray, and these halted production on a lot of things here.
Yeah, Wolverine with another pylon right here. It is much further away this time around. Good creep spread by Delphi. He has really learned from his mistakes in this tournament. I'm very impressed. A transfuse to get that spine crawler up to scratch. And he should be able to defend this without too much of a problem, really.
Yep, definitely. And in it comes Wolverine just pushing around, waiting for another wave of units first. But I don't think he can do it. This is going to be very, very hard. The percentage of this working probably down at about 20%, possibly less. Three queens as well.
Yep, his army supply is slightly behind, but it doesn't matter because worker supply is more than double of Wolverine's right now. This push would probably be blunted. We'll find out if he's able to take the Spore Crawlers out, then, of course, he's going to have a lot of problems with that Void Ray, but he's not going to let that happen. He has creep. There is no observer there to deal with the creep. He has a huge amount of mobility. He's even got Roach Speed coming in for the follow-up if need be. Wolverine can't enter this base right now.
No, it's so heavily defended. And I'm trying to say, is he going to go for an X-Bow? Is he just going to go in? I don't know.
Are you suggesting that Wolverine will build more than one base? That's impossible. It can't be done. Right now, we have three queens. A very small... Void Rate down! Oh, my God. Why? Oh, dear Lord. That was really the only chance he actually had, honestly. And now everything swarms in. Wolverine. And Delphi is going to take bloody, bloody revenge right here on Wolverine. However, he needs to stop trying to charge those force fields. Hold back. There is no need to lose units unnecessarily like that. He's got a Hydralis Den that's almost about to complete. He's got plenty of units. Don't get cocky. Let him come to you.
And here we go. Engagement here. Nice force fields, but I don't think that's enough. A lot of roaches here.
Yeah, it's pretty good, honestly. He's taking a lot of fire. He's micromanaging quite nicely, though. Delphi able to bring that one back. The roach counters look pretty good. Reinforcements will come in, but once again... Why engage away from the Spinecrawlers? He's got three Spinecrawlers. Fight him there. Fight him where you have that advantage. Delphi is throwing away units right now. I know he can afford to do it, but don't get cocky.
7 Hydras in production. And I think that's going to be the end of Warbreak. Yeah. I'm actually sitting here. It's like a really bad movie. Like, trying to watch this game.
You're chilling.
Like,
yeah.
I'm chilling, man. It's like a really bad, bad film.
You can see the plot twist coming a mile away, that kind of thing. I don't know about that yet. Delphi really needs to be more careful. Try and catch Wolfright on the back foot. He does have the Hydralisks in there right now. That will help. Falls once again back to the spine crawl line. Sensible play. Get conservative. He's not expanded. You know he hasn't expanded. You have overlords all over the goddamn place. You don't need to worry about that. You have the economic advantage. Don't throw it away by charging into those guns, charging at those force fields. This might be the push that ends Wolfright's force. A lot of Hydralisk firepower raining down right now on Wolfright. No force fields, no Guardian Shield, no hope in hell. Warp in from the back. 2 Zealots will get instantly torn apart by the looks of it. Hydralisk caught at the front, which is not so great, but needless to say, Delphi still has this for the time being. Reinforcements will come in. He's got 7 more Roaches ready to reinforce this. His +1 missile attack almost complete. GG, ladies and gentlemen, there you go. Delphi advances. Wolfright is knocked out. Finally, the 4 Gateway Protoss has met his match, and Delphi with one of the best 4 gate defenses I've ever seen, to be honest.
Jumps off the stage like a crazy Zerg player.
Like
a boss. Smack that nerd, goes over there, slaps him. Stop 4 gating me. What is this?